The Ontario Federation of Anglers and Hunters proudly presents Angler and Hunter Television. Brought to you by Canadian Tire, Burris Optics, Mercury Marine and Lund Boats, Yamaha ATVs, Browning Ammunition, Browning Firearms, Suffolk Fishing Line, Rapala, Camillus Knives and Cuda Tools, Excalibur Crossbows, and Yukon Gear.
The trend of eating sustainably harvested organic food is more popular than ever, to the point where many urban dwellers have started raising their own livestock, like chickens, and even planting gardens in any available space they can find. This certainly is a good trend, and one that has been a long time coming. However, it's something that anglers and hunters have been doing since we settled this continent hundreds of years ago. The common misconception about anglers and hunters is that we're just out looking for something to hang on our wall or to brag about our success on social media. Now, I'd be lying if I said I don't want to catch the fish of a lifetime or take down a 10-point buck, but the fact is, we're doing it for substance and to do our part in managing wildlife, all while enjoying the great outdoors in this wonderful country of ours. All right, well, it's early in the morning. You hear the birds chirping. I'm hopefully going to catch some walleye. Now, Southern Ontario, Kawartha Lakes, really busy, really close to the Greater Toronto Area. Lots of walleye in them, though. And, you know, people travel all over Canada and North America chasing walleye. But, you know, if you're local, if you just want to, you know, get a small boat or you have a cottage, you want to take a drive for an hour out of the city and go fishing, there's lots of walleye in these lakes. They are weedy lakes, the Kawartha Lakes, so you kind of got to fish them differently, and that's what I'm going to do today. I'm going to be looking for weed lines, you know, in a 9 to 12 feet of water. And basically, the early morning, I'm going to be spending most of the time on the fringe weeds on the edge. And then as the sun gets higher and it warms up, I'll move into the weeds and actually start dunking pockets. So I'm going to use two rods. I've got a 7'1" medium action. This is an Omen rod by 13 Fishing. It's a new company that's coming into Canada. It makes some really nice stuff. And basically I've got 6-pound Suffolk fluorocarbon tied directly to a 1/4-ounce jig head. And with that, I'll be able to feel the walleye if they snap on that jig and pull them through the weeds and cut the weeds with that braid. And then my heavier rod is same thing. It's a 7'1", but it's a medium heavy action, and I'm going to be throwing a storm swimming shad, like a perch style bait, and I'm going to actually dunk it in pockets. Once those fish move in there when the sun gets high, you can actually just vertically jig pockets and pull walleye out of them, ideally. So simple setup. It's going to be just a black or a white twister tail I'm going to be throwing, and this is the VMC Moon Eye jig. It's got a 3D holographic eye in it. When it drops down into those weeds, that eye reflects light. And if you actually watch bait fish scattering in the weed bed, you see their scales reflecting light. So it's a pretty good bait. And that's all there is to it. You know, it's gonna take a lot of feel. I'll use the hummingbirds here. I'll drive around and look for some spots, and I'll try and show you what I'm looking for on the map. And it's pretty straightforward. Other than that, you just look for sparse weed on the edges in 10 or 12 feet, cast that jig out, and bounce it off bottom and lift it back to you. And if you feel a snap on that line, set the hook.
This portion of Angler and Hunter Television brought to you by Yamaha ATVs.
Walleye are one of the most sought-after game fish in North America.
I got one!
Mostly because they're one of the finest to eat.
Awesome. Sorry.
The Kawartha Lakes region of South Central Ontario have healthy populations of walleye.
Look at that, snap right through the snout.
Thanks to government-enforced slot limits, meaning anglers can only keep walleye between 35 and 50 centimeters on most lakes.
Kawartha Lakes walleye. I'm gonna have a fish fry.
So my mission today is to catch a few walleye for a fresh fish dinner.
That's a walleye. Oh, that's a beauty. I'm gonna have to net him. You gotta be careful though. You look down and you see all these thick weeds. He's right on the edge. Oh. That's a walleye in the boat right there. Early morning. On the weed line. That's a good looking fish. Check his length. I think he's got to be a releaser. If he's over 19 inches, yep, just over 19. So, catch and release. Watch this little pickerel go swimming. Bye. So, that just is another perfect example of, you know, why conservation works. I mean, catch and release fishing is the answer. And when you see how many boats come out to the Kawartha Lakes on a weekend in the spring and summer, how many people are actually fishing, these lakes can afford that pressure and handle that pressure because they have slot limits on their walleye. And if it's, you know, basically between 13 and 18 and 3/4, or I like to use, you know, 14 to 18 inches, I'll keep. Anything under 14, I'll let go, and anything over 18, I'll let go. And that fish was prime walleye. Hey, that's a cool walleye, hey? There he goes. But yeah, so when you're, you know, fishing in the Kawartha Lakes in southern Ontario, a measuring stick's important tool to have, so you can check out those slot limits and make sure you're within the parameters of the law. But as the day goes on and it gets hot and sunny here, I'm going to move into that weed bed and I'm going to start dunking some pockets. You know, it's not conventional walleye fishing, but when you actually dunk that jig down in a pocket vertically and see your line jump or feel a thwack, and you can pull up a, you know, 18 or 20 inch walleye out of there, it's pretty cool. Hopefully we'll get to do it here.
A sensitive rod is a must, as walleye often snap up the jig and can often spit it out just as fast as they pick it up.
Oh, you see that? My line just got torqued on the drop. You see that, didn't you?
Yep.
Wham!
So a fast tip will let you feel the bite and set the hook quickly.
Well, that's a good one. I'm gonna need the net for this one. Oh, maybe not. It's another eater. Out on the fringe. I was gonna put the lucky strike to him, but I'm gonna swing him. I like swinging these walleye in. Boom. Perfect. Go right over there to the measuring stick. Watch this. Instant walleye measuring. 17 incher. Whoa, take it easy. The old moon eye snapped him up. That's another good eater. Beautiful. Just beautiful. Boy, it's fast. Snap. You're only in 8 to 10 feet of water, so look at that. Right there. There's a walleye ran in a boat in 11 feet of water. I'm gonna drop right to him. Just like that. He's right ornery. I should have just brought the little Lucky Strike B4 net. Line's good. Everything's good. Oh, I don't want to get stabbed in. There. Whew. Bingo. Smashed at that guy. I'll just do a quick measurement, but I guarantee you this guy's an eater.
So he's just under 17. Perfect walleye.
All right. Keep it on. Keep it on. Keep it on.
Ooh, we're on to something.
This portion of Angler and Hunter Television brought to you by Minn Kota and Humminbird.
The Kawarthas are relatively shallow, fertile lakes, and the best place to find walleye after the water warms up and post-spawn fish have relocated to summer hangouts is on weedlines. Early and late in the day, walleye can be very aggressive.
Oh, it's nice walleye.
But come midday, the fish move into the heavy weeds, which means looking pockets vertically.
There's a perfect example, eh? Look at the weeds on them. It's getting hot, sunny, I took my sweater off. And I caught another eater. Easy. I'd love to use the lucky strike on some of these, but you know what? You don't need to, just lift them in the boat. I'll talk a little bit later. I'll go through the line I'm using and all that stuff to give you a feel. And so when you come out here and try and do this, your head will be in the right place, but almost too small. I'm going to measure this guy.
Oh, he's going to be perfect. Oh, 16, just over 16 inches.
So, you know, I said it earlier. These are just eater size, you know, perfect for eating. Just a little bit small, this guy, but I've got a few here, so I'll start letting them go after this, but for a few walleye fillets, that's all you need. 16 to 18 inch walleye. And look at the weeds I'm drifting into.
Snap.
We can catch another one.
But the trick is the moon eye jig. Don't let anybody tell you differently. The eyes reflecting the light makes them mad.
My most productive technique is a lift and drop, letting the jig hit bottom and then lifting it up a few inches. Repeat this at various speeds till you find what's triggering the bite.
So, I'm no fisheries biologist, but I know that walleye eat perch. I fillet enough of them and see what's in their stomachs, and leeches, and the odd time crayfish. So a perch imitating lure obviously works good, and you know, something dark, a leech imitating lure, like a grub looks like a leech. If you're going to rip bucktails, you can come in these weeds and rip bucktails, but it's a pretty complicated process. But black bucktails or green and yellow bucktails work good. Perch colors, leech colors.
Being patient and methodical is important, as you may go 20 minutes between bites. But you have to be ready at all times, because most fish come in quick flurries.
So you can see how windy it was this morning. The sun's high. It's flattening out. It's getting hot. Now I'm going to start dunking. But I don't use the grubs. I use a storm swim shad. And that bait right there falls straight down, and you just drop it into pockets like this. Hold on, because when they're in there, they eat it. But this is ideal conditions, how it calmed down, got nice and hot. I could see the pockets and drop into that doom hole. Oh yeah, oh my. That was right down in that dark. There, look at this walleye coming up. Oh, he's a good one. He's buried in the weeds. Come on. Got him. That's a bigger fish. I guarantee you he's gonna be over the slot. Oh, lost my flipper, running to the back. Whoa, 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 now you fight. Oh, look at that. That's what he's spitting up. And then look at this bait. So that's a storm perch, and look at the bait he's spitting up. Same size. Walleye down in the weeds. He's almost 22 inches, so he's way over the slot. Breeding stock, going back. Oh, there he goes. Holy, there you go, what a change. I mean, it's hot, there's not a stitch of wind, it's flat. And just like clockwork, I moved into the weeds and started dunking pockets with that perch and caught the biggest walleye of the day. Start off in the fringe, deeper water in the morning, and move into the heavy cover during the day. It's kind of like bass fishing, I guess, but these fish you can eat. And you saw it spit up, you know, a perch about same length as that, 2 3/4, 3 inches. That's what they're eating. But when a fish like that is down in a pocket, it heads right into the thick weeds. So you need that braid to pull him up through it. And you saw that. He didn't put up much of a fight, but I had to drag him up through those weeds.
The Fishing Edge is brought to you by Minn Kota and Humminbird.
To get the edge over the fish, I use the Lund 1875 Pro V Bass and Mercury 200 Pro XS. Humminbird's Helix 10 side imaging made locating weed lines a cinch, and the Minn Kota Ultrex let me easily track along the outside edges. I used a super sensitive 13 Fishing Omen 7'1" medium heavy rod and a 13 Fishing Cree GT reel, spooled with 10-pound Suffix braid and a 6-pound Suffix fluorocarbon leader. A 1/4-ounce VMC Neon Moon Eye jig and a twister tail was all I needed. A Lucky Strike net made sure all the fish came in the boat, and of course, a Cuda fillet knife made quick work of the fish I kept.
It's deeper than it looks here. You know, you look down and you just see thick weeds. And I mean, even on the Humminbird, it sees the weeds and thinks it's 2 feet deep. That's the number you see. But actually, this red line at the bottom, that's the bottom of the lake. And that's 8 feet, 8.5 feet, 9, sometimes 11. So that's why if you cast this jig and try and reel it in, you're gonna get snagged. The trick is to just drift over top with your trolling motor. And you don't have to fish straight up and down, but drop it into pockets and on the weed line, on the edges, and if you hit a weed, rip it through and drop it again. And that's again why I'm using braid. But it's so important to watch your line as it falls. And also try and control the drop. Don't just let it drop on slack line. I'll show you here. Because what happens if you control that drop or watch your line, walleye hit fast. You'll feel the snap or you'll actually see it. So I can lower it down like this with my rod until it hits bottom. And just give it a shake, rip it through the weeds. Do it all over again. It's like bass fishing. You just dunk those pockets. Look at me, come straight up out of there. Easy now. 4 feet of water. Oh, open up that little snapping mouth of yours. Perfect walleye. So if you look, see how thick this mat is? Everywhere there's a little black pocket. You just, like right here, you just dunk that down. As soon as it hits bottom, give it a shake, and a lot of times, snap, they'll nail it. He didn't even have a chance to fight or anything. He didn't know he was hooked. I hit the hook, lifted him in. When it's hot like this, it can really work well. And I mean, you couldn't throw a lure or a crankbait, or you couldn't even cast and retrieve this here. The weeds are so thick. But you just find a pocket, let it fall straight into that pocket, and watch your line, because a lot of times it'll jump on the way down. Here's a really good one right here, full of perch.
It only takes a few slot-sized walleye to make a decent meal, and after a great morning on the water, nothing beats the sizzle of walleye fillets hitting hot oil.